Most people in life are looking for how do I make a life worth living and retirement worth having. When we do things like this in the world, we're telling people how important it is to get serious about your life, to focus on building a career, and to figure out how to make your profession as successful as you hold it dear. Because if you are slow and if you're a playtime girl or guy, you may never get out of the retail world. Not that there's anything wrong with it. I know many people who actually love working in retail. They survive on it. They thrive on it. But they're always in hourly positions, or they're in partially hourly positions and partially management positions. But a lot of the management positions are taken by, well, people who know how to manage money predominantly and manage the stock and the vendors and all those things that are part of the making of money in a retail world. When we're working in our own business, when we're providing a service, it's a totally different kind of concept, because we have to determine what is our hourly wage going to be and how are we going to apply it across the annum, or annually, if you will, in order to cover our life, cover our taxes, cover everything that makes us, well, the living that we want to see. In our life, we have responsibilities, and those responsibilities include having a shelter, which is your first S, having sustenance, which is, of course, your food and your beverages, which is your second S, and third, providing that service so you can cover all of that, or so that you can purchase services like your telephone or your internet network or your gas for your vehicle for getting you to work or through the parts of networking of your business. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth about the world, that if you choose to be an employee in a company, that employee means that you will have your salary chosen for you, that your benefits will be outlined in some sort of pamphlet once you get a 40-plus hour a job week, and openly it means your time will be managed predominantly by what you do, but by the company hour and time clock of when you need to arrive and when you can leave, and how much is going to be your overtime is something that they may or may not apply to you. If you're an entrepreneur, then you have to do the difference in turning out how you're going to manage the time of your work week, what's called the business week, of how you use your Monday and how you use yourself all the way across through to what most entrepreneurs know as Sunday, which is either prep for the new week or clean up for the old week. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth about what goes on in the real world. And if you're working at a low-end job, that is the choice you made for yourself. If you're doing it because it's now your retirement and you did something different for your main career, then probably you've found that it's hard to retire unless you have millions in the bank. The reality is that most people do not have millions in the bank at the time that they need to retire. The lucky few, the dot-com boomers, things like that, people who came from perhaps wealth to begin with, may know how to build wealth, may know how to buy stocks and bonds, may know how to trade different type of currencies, like I had a fella in college I used to know who used to do, and that's how he made his extra cash to be living high on the hog in college. But truth be known, if we don't learn how to do that young, we may not get out of the concept of always having to work. Because when you work, you create your hourly wage. Even if you are a business owner, there is still at some point the concept of marketing math, which establishes what is your hourly wage and what will taxes be, what will your take home be, and so on and so forth. And what do the expenses require as a part of your business and your look? Now in life, I can tell you the truth or I can lie to you, but I prefer to tell you the truth about the real world. That during the time of COVID, a lot of places were in downturn and they were not hiring at all. Some places now are actually hiring, but that's not the point. The point is that people are starting to take their masks off, people are starting to hold hands a lot more, and people are starting to re-engage once again in the vivid living world.